Hello everyone, welcome to my video. In this video, I'm going to talk about some fantastic functions of Google Colab. And many of the functions are also being used by Jupyter Notebook. So let's see here. This is my file inside Google Colab. What if I accidentally close this file? Where to get it back? Well, you can just go to your Google Drive using the same Google account. Click on My Drive. And here you'll look for a folder that's called Colab Notebooks. Just double click on this folder. And inside this folder, you're going to see all your Google Colab files listed out here. And just click on the file, you're going to get it back. See, I have two cells here inside this file. And let's see here, for the first cell, I click on anywhere inside the cell to select the whole cell, and I can use this delete button to delete the cell. Well, what if I accidentally delete a cell and I want to get it back? No worries, just click anywhere outside any cell and just select three buttons together, Control plus M plus Z. Okay. And now it's back. So let's select the first cell. Anywhere inside it, you can select it. And what if I remove this line accidentally and I want to get it back? Well, if it's inside the cell, so first make sure that you select the whole cell. You are inside the cell. Click anywhere inside it. And then hit Control plus Z button. And it's back. So it's fantastic. You can also adjust any order of any cell. So what if I want to move this cell down? I can click the down button and it's down. I can also click the up button to move it up. So you can change the position of any cell. And also because Google Colab allows us to write to put our coding into different blocks, into different cells, we can run them separately or we can run them together. For example, if I select the first cell, I can actually choose, for example, runtime, run all. That means just run all the two cells together. You can see both of them are running and the output are there. Or you can select the cell that you want to run only, for example, the second cell. So hit, click on run and selection. For example, you run the cell that you select. And also inside Google Colab, we can create new section title to kind of separate different content and divide them into different sections. For example, after the second cell, I want to create a new section. What I can do is that I can hit insert, section, header, cell, and double click on here. I can do the editing, change the name of the section, just name it my second section. And then I can insert another cell below this section that's going to be my new cell under the new section. So you can see the section title is not a coding. Python will not run this one, but I can add more coding after my section title so that Python can run them.